I would never, ever say that.
We got that camera.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry.
No, it's fine. Yeah.
Yep. Nan. Maybe I care. Maybe you don't. Maybe I'll let go. Maybe you won't. Could there be two of us? Could there be two? Hello, I'm Celeste and I'm a musician.
I'm Paria and I'm a menswear designer.
I just prepare for a show really by being as calm as I can for the day leading up to the evening of the show. I try to plan my outfit like as early on as I can. I don't really work with a stylist at the moment because I just feel it's important for me to go out feeling natural and feeling comfortable in what I'm wearing. It's about just like preserving my energy and my voice as well.
A show is kind of like the same, obviously, like you're still preparing for it months on. The best thing to do is just stay on the ground, because as soon as you realise that you're not on the ground, then it goes spiralling. So stay calm, drink lots of tea, vervain, that's go-to.
Yeah.
It's the most calming one.
Do you have any funny stories?
One time there was Rihanna, only girl in the world, not her physically, but my mum helps out a lot with production and showtime, so she just started dancing and she doesn't drink, so it was really intense. Just try and imagine that.
her dancing
just
to her, only girl
whilst
in the
everybody
world.
Else was working.
Okay.
On her own.
I've got a story similar, probably, like my nan coming to my shows and her being nicknamed like Mosh Pit Nan, because I was like supporting this band and they did this particular song, like there'd be like this massive mosh pit and my nan would always end up in the middle of it because she hadn't like left the area yet. So yeah, like, yeah, the vicinity
away,
of moshing.
Yeah.
Creating merch to sell and maybe even to gift people at my shows and stuff. Collaborating with like a designer like Paria, or even like graphic designers, on making something that isn't just my face on a t-shirt with my name on it kind of thing, something that feels wearable for every day.
I'm gonna go with Evian. Really,
oh, yes.
Just who doesn't like water? Everybody can design a bottle and then you'd be like, oh, it's an exclusive bottle. But what I would do would be just so interactive and I really wanna do something with Evian, so Evian. You're watching.
I can imagine that happening.
Yeah.
Somebody asked me this question the other day, and I wasn't necessarily sure yet if I believe in necessarily like a creative slump or like writer's block. If you're a writer or a designer or photographer, you will always have the ability within you to like continue to do that. It's just some days you're more inspired than others.
I completely agree with Celeste. I mean, I've been in a position where you're like, why is nothing happening? I think it's just the problem of feeling so under pressure sometimes. The best thing to do is have horse blinders on. You literally just see, you just have tunnel vision and you can't see what's going on around you.
Well, I met Paria in London.
Aww.
We met from going out. Like, this wouldn't be happening if we didn't go out to the same place and interested in the same thing. So that's kind of one of the things that I've gained from moving here from Brighton, is that like I actually am getting to meet and be a part of all these things that I admired before.
Well, I lived in Hull most of my life, so Hull is the East Riding of Yorkshire. You find it hard to breathe in this city and you feel like there's too much going on, but if I didn't live here, then the same.
Yeah,
you wouldn't be
it.
In this opportunity. London is definitely a hub of placing people together in times when you don't know it at all. A lot of my friends are musicians, so, you know, as soon as they do something, it's instantly on in the studio and we're listening to it purely because I don't work in silence, so we can go from KEB on a mission to Celeste and then some Mozart in the middle, and then we'll go to, what did we have the other day? Tiger Taste, you know, like there's no line. I like the feeling of how one song can take you to a particular moment in any part of your life. I aim to have my clothes to be transportive. I want to take somebody somewhere, and that's what music does for me. So I guess it's such a big part of designing my collections.
That's a cool answer. Yeah, I think for me personally, even from a young age, fashion was sort of like an aspirational thing for me growing up. And definitely as I've sort of been able to make music and be around these people, it's been one of the things that has maybe inspired me to work harder to be able to get the things that I want, whether that's a good thing or a bad thing. But I grew up in a very working class family, and you see all of these things that you want to have for yourself. It definitely made me work harder to get them. I also am, I guess, just inspired by like a particular aesthetic, and that's something that I would like to execute in my own visuals and looks for my shows and everything like that.
I believe the biggest risk is not taking one. So I'm a risk taker. Someone's like, you can't go over there, I will go there. If you want to jump, then you will jump, because you just never know.
Yeah.
I think the biggest challenge, and still happens for, doesn't matter who you are, where you come from, is just the term no. If you really want something, you can have it. I mean,
that's very true.
There's two people sat here as an example. We're not on the top of the world, but I know for sure that we were just having this conversation. You should want the universe and more, and nobody can tell you no.
Yeah, I think Paria's just said it. The advice I would have given to my younger self at times when I was probably just like really frustrated and probably crying, thinking like, am I ever going to be able to do the thing that I want to do the most in the way that I want to do it? I would have just said to like, be calm and carry on. Not like that stupid slogan. I don't want to say that. I would have said. I don't necessarily think there's like one source of inspiration and there's one particular person that you can be inspired by. I think there's lots of people that come into your life and into your periphery that sort of spur you on to do what you're doing, whether it's your family because you recognise that they're working hard to achieve something, or what they've done to sort of provide a certain lifestyle for you. When I was younger, I used to watch videos of like Edith Piaf and Marlene Dietrich and Diana Ross on repeat on YouTube, and certain like elements of their live performance has really inspired me, and something that I study to hope to bring elements of that into my live show. I take a lot of inspiration from jazz and soul, and naturally that music filters into hip hop because it's just, it's lived and breathed in that culture. I think it's important, like, for me to just listen to everything I possibly can, so then I can kind of work from the best viewpoint. In terms of style, I think, I guess I took a lot of inspiration from the people around me growing up. I actually really often like a lot more what my male friends are wearing than some of my female friends. So, yeah.
I think Celeste is right. I totally agree. Like, especially the family part, for example, mum and dad, and you're like, oh my God, like, look at you, like 30 years out of the Middle East and you're here. And that to me is inspiring because they've been able to give you something that you never thought that you could have. It's so important to have just normal people, you know, we're all normal. Everybody's an inspiration. It just depends how you take and how you feel around them. A really weird one for me is David Blaine. Like, I just think he is insane. This person can change a room's atmosphere. He's not really around anymore and people don't really like look into magic and the dark arts. Star-wise for me would be McQueen, because again, somebody who didn't care and was ready to make people feel uncomfortable because he wanted people to take risks in their life.
Even sort of like how the ideas would come to him for concepts for the whole show, and every single part of that would live and breathe that concept, whether it was down to how the models would walk or like a tear in one of the skirts or something. I think he's amazing too. Yeah. Like a few years ago, I supported Roy Ayers at the Jazz Cafe. I'd listened to his music growing up, and we played this show, then he invited me into his dressing room after. He just was like, when's your birthday? Sorry about the accent. He was like, when's your birthday? And I told him the 5th of May. And then he was just like, Miles was a Taurian. And I was thinking like, who is he talking about? And then he was like, Miles Davis, duh. Wow. And I was like, okay, that's very cool to know that I'm standing in front of you, and at one point you were probably standing with Miles Davis and having some sort of similar conversation.
Mine's not really a backstage moment, but it kind of would be. I met Mos Def maybe a year or so ago. He actually came up to me and said, oh, I know you. And I'm like, what? You should be the other way round. So I grew up listening to his music, and I don't know, it's just kind of very weird when you hear one of your idols come up to me, I know you, you're that designer, blah, blah, blah. So I was kind of just taken back. But I think it's always
like a
faint.
Different sort of recognition, yes, to somebody just coming up to you and saying, you're, yeah, really good.
Yeah.
You know, it means a lot when those people that you look up to recognise what you're doing.
Absolutely.
And appreciate it.
Yeah, for sure.
I heard it's in your blood, babe. I heard you got